sa aming paniniwala, nararapat lamang po na madisbar ang mga miyembro ng Aegis Juris Fraternity na sangkot sa tangkang pagtatakip sa krimeng naganap. Sila ay ang mga sumusunod: lawyers Marby Abo, Alston Kevin Anarna, Edsel Bert Canlas, Cecilio Jimeno, Ferdinand Rogelio, Eric Fuentes, Cesar Ocampo Ona, Gaile Dante Caraan, Henry Pablo Jr., Jet Villaroman, Cesar De La Puente, Nino Jel Cervantes, Manuel Angelo Ventura III, Michael Vito, Nilo Divina, Arthur Capilli, Irvin Joseph Fabella, Edwin Uy, Alan Christopher Agati, and all other members to be determined to have had knowledge of Atio's death and failed to report the same to the authorities. Mr. President, it is undeniable that these lawyers have lost their moral fabric and became undeserving to be part of this noble and dignified profession. As such, upon adoption of this report, we will furnish the Supreme Court a copy of our report together with all the documents received by your committee. May these documents be used as reference in the disbarment proceedings which we expect the court to institute. Sa ating katastasang hukuman, sana po mapatunayan ninyo sa lahat ng sumubaybay sa kwento ni Atio na mali ang sabi-sabi na walang mangyayari dahil malakas ang kanilang mga koneksyon at makakalimutan rin ang isyong ito. With respect to the University of Santo Tomas, an institution known as, and I quote, the Royal and Pontifical Catholic University of the Philippines, unquote, the maintenance of a morally encouraging educational environment will be endangered should they continuously fail to meet the demands of the issue. Notwithstanding established proof as to the actual practice of hazing by a fraternity that has existed in the university for the past 36 years, we have yet to hear any pronouncement or decision perpetually banning the Aegis Juris Fraternity. Mr. President, hanggang sa mga sandaling ito, nakakabingi ang katahimikan at nakakabahala ang kakulangan ng karampatang aksyon ng UST sa trahedyang sinapit ni Atio. As long as the university remains silent in the hope that all this shall pass, members of the fraternity will continue to huddle somewhere and arrogantly blurt out their senseless pretentious chant, lumalakas, lumalawak, lumalaban. Mr. President, Atio Castillo sought to join a brotherhood in search for his purpose in life. There's no more life to speak of. Let his death serve the purpose of ensuring that the misery of hazing and the employment of appalling rituals will no longer be imposed in the name of brotherhood.